Bear with us. We're changing the way that updates are delivered to your devices, both for Windows and for Surface. But we feel that it is for the best, and we're very excited to kind of walk you through what that looks like now with a Surface device running Windows 10.
A few important notes about updates. One thing we have to be cognizant of is that Surface is a first-party device. So because we make the device, we also administer the updates and we send them out. And within that, it's important to note that these firmware updates, anything like correcting an audio driver issue or something like that.
Yeah, it's updating all going a Wi-Fi card.
Yeah, yeah.
Exactly. Those are delivered primarily through Windows Update. Now, we're very aware that a typical IT process is withholding updates until there's a chance to test them. We don't want to confuse users. We're aware of that as well. But we strongly recommend allowing Surface devices in particular direct access to Microsoft's update server. Now, that's a big step, we're aware, but we've added a new feature and a new policy that can be configured by yourselves to effectively manage the device and not have the experience change for users while still allowing your Surface to receive firmware updates and Windows to receive critical security updates. This is called Defer Feature Updates, and it's available as a policy that you can apply. This means that your device will reach Microsoft servers to receive those critical updates, but it will defer any feature updates, anything that changes the user interface or adds any new features, until you would like that to be rolled out to your users. So it gives you that same gated control over your user's experience while still allowing the device to reach the server and be updated effectively. This is important. We've had a couple of instances where Surfaces have required updates. Surface Pro 3 needed a very important Wi-Fi update. There's some updates that we've had for things like the digitizer. And this is part of launching a new machine into the world and making sure that it's ready to go. So we just want to make sure that you have all of your devices updated in a very effective way and that you aren't the reason that a device is still experiencing a problem.
Absolutely. You already also mentioned something interesting, which is that previously with Windows, the update process was that a service pack gets released, you then test it with all of your specific line of business applications before rolling it out to users. It's a really big project, and it happens every couple years or so. We want to shift that mentality with Windows 10, and we want to turn that more into a consistent process. So there's a few ways, a few tips, and a few things that you can set into place that'll help you along that journey to get yourself on par with us with our feature updates every twice a year or so.
Yeah, they are twice yearly, and that is a fast release schedule compared to previous versions of Windows. But I want to emphasize these are not an entire upgrade or a new version of Windows. It is simply an update. It is an in-place update, and compatibility is pretty good. So let's take a look through what this would look like as we're stepping through. We have some suggestions as to how you can plan and prepare, but again, this ultimately lands in your hands as to how it is rolled out in your organization. Of course, you have that piloting phase where some users, maybe that's just your team, have access to the next version of Windows and you're testing it out on your devices.
Also, you may find that there's a group of users within your organization that are early adopters. Maybe they're a little more tech savvy than your average end user. And that's a really great choice for a targeted pilot group. People who are maybe willing to put up with a bug here or there. It's not going to be particularly surprising, and you've worked well with them in the past. So this is a good group of people to be your guinea pigs, if you will.
Right, right. And that's why we have our Windows Insider for Business, which provides those early builds. You can allow people to access it even before we've released it to the public. And then the final step, of course, is broadly deploying that version of Windows to all of your users. So let's talk a little bit about what that release cycle looks like. So let's say you're currently using Windows 10 version 1803. That, by the way, signifies March of 2018, 1803. And you'll see that kind of so on and so forth down the line of our Windows history. So you're able to effectively prepare. It's about 6 months in between each release. And surrounding that 6 month, we have a good amount of time with which you can test. So you might test that version of Windows in your environment for 6 months and then release it just before the next version of Windows is set to be released, and that's perfectly fine. However, I want to emphasize, and this is a bit of a tough change, but one that we feel is necessary, After 18 months, each version of Windows will no longer be supported by Microsoft. That is the end of life for each version of Windows 10. So we are kind of pushing your hand a little bit, bear with us, to update at least every 18 months. So you don't need to do this twice yearly, but at least at that 18-month point, it's time to move to the next version of Windows.
Now, we've heard feedback that you want more consistency from our Windows builds. And so we've announced somewhat recently that our fall builds of Windows are going to be supported for a longer period of time. To check out a little more about that, you can head to TechNet. We'll show you a little more about TechNet later on in another module.
Now, for ease of deployment, we're aligning each major milestone for Office as well. So you can see here, it releases just before each Windows feature update so that you can stay aligned. This also works with Config Manager. So any new policies or things that you need to manage it, this coincides with those releases with an occasional out-of-band release you see there with 17.10 version of Config Manager and so on. Remember those three groups that we had? Here's what that looks like kind of in a timeline. The nice thing about the Windows Insider program for Business is that you can start trialing the next version of Windows almost the next week after we release the current version of Windows, because we are constantly working on it and building Windows 10 in collaboration with the community of people and professionals that are testing Windows around the world. So we recommend that you start doing that, have some devices, maybe a virtual machine, maybe a Surface or two you have at your desk that you can put inside of Windows Insider for Business and start testing the different applications that your users will need throughout their workday. That then goes into, of course, a brief pilot period and then a broad deployment.
One really important reason that we've decided to move to this new update schedule where we do release updates more frequently than we ever have before is because we live in a world where we are constantly at the threat of being attacked. There's a lot of people out there wanting to get into your data, and we want to ensure that we reduce that protection gap as much as possible. And that protection gap happens when we take longer to release each one of those updates. So as more and more time passes between those security updates, you're left vulnerable, your devices are left vulnerable to phishing, malicious attacks, and things like that. So we want to get ahead of that curve as much as possible.
There are some security measures that we can only employ when we do a major update to Windows 10. So a service pack of yesteryear might not have been able to address. The jump in security from Windows XP to Windows 7 was vast. Windows 7 was far more secure, and that is because it was an entirely new operating system. Well, when we're doing this twice yearly, we're able to close that protection gap and roll out very critical, deep-reaching fixes in a much faster pace.
And you already mentioned Windows 7 was incredibly secure. We're really happy to see that Windows 10 is the most secure version of Windows that we've ever released. And there's a lot of reasons for that. At the device level, we have things like Device Guard, we have TPM chips and Windows Hello to ensure that the right people are using the right device at the right time. But then we also have things like Azure Advanced Threat Protection on the cloud side of things to ensure that your data remains safe, even when it's not tangible in front of you.
Of course, when we're talking about updates or upgrades or anything like that, compatibility is first and foremost in mind. So we want to be clear that we are projecting around a 99% compatibility between each update to Windows. There are very few things, and unless they specifically call for this version of Windows or lower, which is not many programs, they all should work just fine between each update. These are just a couple of the things we'll run through. Those desktop apps is where we're seeing that great compatibility. Then we also have compatibility through Edge with Internet Explorer.
Yeah, absolutely. We're seeing more and more progressive web apps are becoming popularized. And so as more content is hosted on the web, we want to ensure that Edge and Internet Explorer are able to keep up with that and always kind of remain evergreen for you.
And then in terms of hardware compatibility, let's take Surface maybe out of the equation for a moment. If you have other devices in your organization and you're wanting to move them into Windows 10, we were very pleased with the launch of Windows 10 that these minimum system requirements are the same, matching Windows 7. So if it is currently running Windows 7, 9 times out of 10, that is going to run Windows 10, no problem.
And if you do find an application that isn't working or isn't working correctly on Windows 10, you can head to fasttrack.com and submit your feedback and let our developers know which applications aren't compatible yet so that we can help you correcting it and make sure that all your line of business apps are working properly.
So all of this together we know is a bit of a shift. Of course, anytime there's updates or changes, it does involve some new processes and a new way of thinking. But we're hoping that over time, the value of this, the added protection, security, and also just making sure your users have all of the features that are developed for them that are included with your purchase of Surface and Windows 10, that they have access in a nice, secure, and compatible way.